We have already configured our PHP Strum to connect with our GitHub, and we have also set up our first repository in our GitHub, which is my blog dash web. And the next thing we need to do is we need to configure our Android project with our GitHub. So let's create one more project over here. To create one more project, we go to repositories and add a new. So let's add a new one we call as my blog dash Android, and let's say this is let's give a same description. Okay, so this would be my blog Android app demo, and let's make it public and let's create a repository. Okay, so this we have already done in our previous lesson. Let's do it one more time. So what we need to do is we need to initialize a git first. So let's say git init. So let's go to our Android Studio, and what we need to do is we need to go to terminal over here, and let's say run a git command over here, and it says that git is not recognized. So what we need to do is we need to close this one first and restart our project again. Okay, our project is up already, and let's close this one and let us run one more time git to check whether git is initialized. Okay, so we can see the git command can be used now. So what we need to do is the same thing we can be also done if we go to this directory, which is user admin document my blog. So if we go to here, C drive, sorry, document and my blog, the same command we can run using a git bash. So just right click over here and use a git bash here. So if we click on here, a git terminal will be open over here. So let's just make it a little bit bigger over here, and let's say we can option and we can say the text size, and let's select the text size of 12. Okay, apply and save. So it's look much bigger, so easier for you guys to see. So if you run the same command over here, it can, you can see we can run the same command over here. So let's use a git bash so you'll be more familiar over, and let's go to our here and say git add readme. So we need to add a readme file first over here, and let's see in our project whether we have any readme file. So we don't have any readme file, so let's add a readme file. Let's go over here and let us add one not inside the app. Let's add one. Let's go to project inside the project. So keep, if you go to the project over here, you can see all the file inside your project. So we go over here and we right click over here and then new file. So let's add a new file is readme.md. okay, it's a text file, and let us add some description. This Android app demo. Okay, just close it. And if you go over here, we can see we have readme file. So the next command we need to run is git and readme. So let's go over here. Let's go to our blog over here and let us try git. Sorry, what we need to run first is git init. We haven't run this command, so we need to initialize our git first. So let's go to git init. Okay, you can see has been initialized, and the next command we need to run is git add readme. So let's add that command, run that command, git add readme.empty. Okay, so we have added that, and the next command we need to run again is a git commit. So before we run a git commit, let's run git status to check. So we can see we have this, all of this file need to be added. So what we need to do first is we need to add git add dot, so which means that add everything inside this directory to git. So which it will add everything from this directory. So it will take all the file inside this directory and add to the git. So on the next command we need to now, so if we run again git status and check all the file, which means has been added to git. So it's the green color. So the next command we need to run over here is git commit. So let's commit it, git commit as m, and let's give a first commit, enter. Okay, so everything is up, right? So it says no error, and the next thing we need to do is add this one. We need to add remote add origin. So let's add our, sorry, let's go here and add origin, just paste it over here and run. Okay, so the last final command we need to run is git push dash u origin master. So let's run this command in our terminal or git bus, just paste it over here, just press enter, and let's see what this does. Okay, so here it has done, and you can see branch master setup track remote. It means that everything is up, we don't have any error. And let's go to our Android myblog.android, and we can see we have our first commit over here. So I think we have successfully made our GitHub repository for myblog-web and myblog-android. So we have a two repository. If you go over to your dashboard, and you can see we have two repository. One is myblog-web and myblog-android. So we have also configured our Android Studio project, and we also have configured our PHP Storm. So that means we have successfully built our GitHub repository on both Android project and also a PHP project. So if you are wondering why we use a git bus, so it's the same thing if you use the terminal over here or the git bus. So I just want you to show how we can use a git bus. And if you run the same command here, git status, you can see nothing added to a commit on track, so which means there is no file changed. If we change any file, then it will detect. So let's say if we delete this hello world from here, and if we try to add a text box, plain text over here, and let's say have some error, let us not try to fix anything first. Okay, let's just try to fix it, and let us try to, okay, so our error is gone over here, and let us try to run the same command over here. Okay, status, here you can see that use git checkout to discard change, you can see modified file. So which file has been currently modified? So which means that currently modified file is this one. So which means we have made some change to our activity underscore main. So let's go back to our Android project over here, and let's go to res over here and layout, and here this is the file that has changed something. So if you see, it's in a blue color. So if you want to add it, so let's say so if we'll add everything, and what we'll do again is git status, so which means our file is added, so it's in green color. So now we can commit. So hope you guys have understand some of the basic uses of a git, and if you go and practice more, I think you will get it more understanding on how it actually works. So if you have any question, do let me know, and I will see you in the next video. Till then, have a great day.